We need to make sure that we improve ourselves in order to be able to resolve matters and problems. Don't always point a finger at the others. Remember, as you are pointing the finger at the others, the rest of the fingers are pointing back at you. You need to consider that you might be wrong. You need to make amends. You need to make sure that you listen attentively to what is being said. When people have a complaint, be it against you or the situation that happens to be troublesome, when you talk about it, listen, and listen carefully and listen attentively. Sometimes we don't even give people a chance to communicate. They become frightened. They don't want to raise the matter simply because they are petrified of us. How we will react, what we will say. If that's the case, surely you need to improve yourself. Surely you need to improve yourself. Give people a chance to speak. Don't react in an emotional outburst. Put your emotions aside. And that is how you will be able to deal with problems. If you become very emotional, you're not going to be able to deal with the matters. But if you put your emotions aside, you listen to people, you calm down, you react in a beautiful manner, you try to solve the problem. Listen to what the Quran says. إن يريد إصلاحا يوفق الله بينهما. A beautiful verse. Allah says, if both parties really want to solve the problem, if both parties want to solve the problem, Allah will grant them acceptance to do so. Don't let it be a match where one person is in it not to solve the problem, but to prove who was right and who was wrong. If you are trying to prove who was right and wrong, you're not going to solve the problem. But it should be greater than that. It's okay if I was actually right, but I don't want to mention that because at the moment I'd like to solve the problem. Are you prepared to take a promise from your spouse or from a family member that I will not repeat this behavior or these words or what I've done, and I promise that? Are you prepared to take a promise? True love would ensure that you trusted them once again, or you worked on building the trust. That having been said, we need to make sure that we don't give people reason to mistrust us. That's very important. People say, you must learn to trust me, but you're giving me reason to mistrust you. Let me take a moment to say Bismillah and close this umbrella, right? MashaAllah. MashaAllah. I'm thankful to Allah that we actually continued. Alhamdulillah. So we need to be prepared to sacrifice a little bit for those whom we love, those whom we have come together using the name of Allah with. When we got to the masjid, for example, or there was an officiation of a nikah, what did we do? We used the name of Allah, we said the name of Allah, didn't we? Verses were read reminding us of being conscious of Allah. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله. Two types of verses. One addressing mankind at large regarding relationships, and Allah is saying, be conscious of your maker when it comes to the relationships. The other one says, oh you who believe, be conscious of your Lord. Because here you are entering into a relationship, making the family, and you will definitely need to bear Allah in mind. If my aim in life is to please my creator, and your aim in life is to please your creator, we have already minimized the problems that we are going to face. And if we do face them, we have increased the chances of resolving them, because my aim and intention is to please the maker.